another important topic is Wheatstone's bridge. Wheatstone's bridge. In a Wheatstone bridge, in this, four resistances are taken along the four sides of a quadrilateral. ABCD is a quadrilateral, and along four sides, P, Q, R, S, they are the four, along the four sides, what we have taken the resistances. Four, along the four sides of a quadrilateral, along one diagonal, a galvanometer is connected. Now, quadrilateral has got two diagonals. Along one diagonal, what we do? We connect galvanometer. And along another diagonal, we connect a cell. Along one diagonal, a galvanometer is connected. And along other diagonal, a cell is connected. If we interchange their positions, it hardly matters. But it should be clear that along one diagonal, there should be galvanometer. So, along another diagonal, the cell should be connected. Done? Now, these resistances are arranged in such a manner, we arrange in such a manner that no current flows through the galvanometer. And under this condition, which condition? When no current flows through the galvanometer, under this condition, it is seen that P upon Q is equal to R upon S. And the bridge is said to be balanced. If P upon Q is R upon S, the vice versa. No current flow, if no current flows, this is seen. And we say that the bridge is balanced. Proof of Wheatstone bridge. Suppose the current I starts flowing in the circuit at the junction A, it will distribute. Suppose along this side, current I1 goes, and along this side, current I2 flows. As no current passes the galvanometer, I1 will go through resistance R also, and I2 will go through resistance S. Ultimately, both will combine at C and we'll get IVM. Now, applying Kirchhoff's second law in loop ABDA. ABDA. I'm going to apply Kirchhoff's second law in this loop and I'm taking direction clockwise as positive. It states that the product of current and resistance, the current is I1, resistance is P. I1P. Now why positive? Current is also going this side and you also going this side. Same direction, positive. Now no current here. Coming to this side, it is current is I2, resistance is Q. Multiply I2Q, I2Q. Now I2 is going this side and you are going opposite to this. So minus I1P minus I2Q is equal to net EMF. As there is no cell, so net EMF is almost 0. It is 0. This becomes I1P is equal to I2Q. This is equation 1. I am taking another loop BCDB. Loop BCDB. Again, I am taking clockwise direction. Clockwise direction. I1R, same direction, positive. I2S, you are going this side, and I2 is going this side, is opposite. So minus I2S, net EMF, no cell here, it is 0. Becomes I1R due to I2S, equation 2. Now equation 1 divided by equation 2. This is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. Divide both, we get P upon R is equal to Q upon S, or you can write P upon Q due to R upon S. This is your proof of Wheatstone bridge. Now we'll see meter bridge. The simple diagram I have drawn here. This MN is a wire of length 100 cm, or in other words, 1 meter. RB stands for resistance box, where we will take out different resistances. And S is unknown resistance. Now let me tell you, what is the first meter bridge? It is a sensitive device which is used to find unknown resistance and works on the principle of Wheatstone bridge. Here, it is a sensitive device which is used to find unknown resistance and works on the principle of Wheatstone bridge. So this is the unknown resistance which we will be finding with the help of meter bridge. Again repeating, ML is a wire of length 100 cm or 1 meter. RB resistance box, S is unknown resistance. Cell, all of you know, this is a rheostat and this is a key. Now this is jockey and galvanometer is here. Now what we do, when we switch on the circuit, current will start flowing. Now with the help of jockey, we find the that point at which this shows zero deflection. With the help of jockey instrument, we just tap it on the wire. With the help of jockey, we find that point at which galvanometer shows zero deflection. Now suppose it is showing zero deflection at length L from the side, length L. So remaining will be 100 minus L. So when jockey is placed at point J, that is at length L, galvanometer shows zero deflection. Clear? That means what? Not this bridge is balanced. Suppose the resistance of wire MJ is P and resistance of this much length is Q, then in the balanced Wheatstone bridge, what we get? R upon P is equal to S upon Q, where S is the known resistance, P is the resistance of part MJ and Q is the resistance of part JN. We want S is equal to Q upon P into R. Clear? Now, the relationship between resistance and length, we know it is resistance is equal to rho L upon A, where rho is the resistivity of the wire MN. So for P, it will be length is how much? L. And A, where A is the area of cross section of wire, MN. Similarly, how to find out Q? Q will be rho, now length is 100 minus L upon A. And the wire is same, so resistivity is same. We want Q upon P, so from this side, find out Q upon P. So Q upon P will be equal to 100 minus L upon L. Keeping these values here, we get S is equal to 100 minus L upon L into R. In this method, we find an unknown resistance. R to the resistance, you know, you are taking it from the resistance box. With the help of jockey, we just need to find out null point. When L is the null point, we can read it from the scale, it is a meter scale. So this S is the unknown resistance. This is your meter base.